Alright, so I'm going to very quickly talk about four different processes that cause magmas to change over time. So if we have a magma, I'm going to just draw a nice lovely little diapira blob of magma rising up through some surrounding rock. I'm going to put little X's just to show that it's been crystallized. Okay, so we have this magma that's rising up. Magmas don't necessarily come up as a big blob, but they might have extensions that kind of go up. And they're going to start to wrap around chunks of the pre-existing rock. So let's say that this one kind of goes and it closes up and it takes a piece of this rock and it brings it inside. What's going to start to happen is it's going to assimilate that piece of country rock, that surrounding cool rock. It's going to melt it and take that material, all of those chemicals that are inside of that rock, and those are going to become melted down and become part of the magma. This actually works to take that magma and over time make it more and more felsic. Okay, so this is the process of assimilation of that surrounding country rock. Okay, another thing that can happen as the magma is moving up, we're going to call this one A. There might be a second blob of magma that's rising up, and we'll call it B. And if they start to merge and join together, they're going to kind of cross bounds, and they're going to start to mix so that B becomes part of A. Now, if A, let's say A were an intermediate magma, and maybe B was a mafic magma, so we take an intermediate and a mafic, and we're going to combine those two, we're going to see sort of a composition between that mafic and intermediate. Okay, so that intermediate is going to become more mafic over time, or we could look at it, and the other way around would be to take this mafic magma that's now mixing in some intermediate magma, that one's going to become more felsic. So that's this process of magma mixing. Okay, the next thing that can start to happen is this fractional crystallization. So if we have that blob of magma and it starts to cool and crystallize out different mineral crystals, okay, those different mineral crystals are denser than the magma that they're sitting in. They're going to start to sink down in the magma, and eventually they're going to accumulate at the bottom. And so this will start to cool and crystallize and turn into a rock. Well, as those crystallize and they've been growing, all of the elements that were present in the magma, the iron, the magnesium, the silicon, the oxygen, they're going to start to take some of those elements out of the magma so that they're no longer available to crystallize into new minerals. So we start to see this stuff down at the bottom will be more magnesium and iron rich than the material at the top. This is the process of fractional crystallization, and it starts to happen as that magma is cooling and crystallizing. The heavier mineral crystals sink down towards the bottom, and we see this change, this fractional crystallization change in the chemistry of the rock that's left behind. Okay. And then the last thing that we can see with magmas changing is just this idea of partial melting. Now, if we were to go to a place where we have a big piece of continental crust, and we'll see maybe it's intermediate in its overall composition, if we get a mantle plume that's rising up and it starts to create a big hot spot, so this is heat sitting underneath that continental plate, that lithosphere, it acts sort of like taking a rock and putting it on a hot plate, although much to a more extreme level. What it actually starts to happen is that this bottom part of that lithospheric plate is going to start to melt. It partially melts, and it's then going to lead up to some new blobs of magma rising up through that lithospheric crust. Now, these blobs are going to be more felsic than the rock that it was originally part of. And that's because when we look at Bowen's reaction series, those light colored minerals, those are going to start to melt back into the magma. Things that are cooling and crystallizing at the lowest temperatures, those are going to be the first to start to melt off and then rise up through the continental crust to create new material. This is just one example of partial melting. It can happen below oceanic lithosphere or continental lithosphere, and it's just changing the material that comes up so that it becomes more felsic over time. So in all of these cases, most of what we're looking at is the rock is going to change from one to the other, and usually we're going to see that happening, that they're becoming more and more felsic over time versus more and more mafic. Again, the idea of the magma mixing, that's one where we might see it becoming a little bit more felsic depending on which two magma types are going to be mixing and the way that you're looking at which one's changing. But again, we start to see things become more felsic over time, and these are four processes that help us understand how that's happening.